Do you know your wound could be infected if not properly cared for? How do you know or recognize or tell that a wound is infected? What are some of the things to do when you have an infected wound? These are some of the things we're going to be talking about. Hi guys, it's Florence, your next door nurse, and you're welcome to another exciting time. Today we're going to be talking about how to recognize infected wounds. It's actually a continuation of my previous video on major wounds. If you've not seen that video, you can click on the link in the description below. To my subscribers, thank you for sticking with me, and to the newbies, you're welcome to the family. Kindly subscribe, like, and share. Gracias. Infected wounds are wounds in which bacteria or other microorganisms have colonized, causing a delay in wound healing or deterioration of the wound. It results when the body's immune defenses are overwhelmed or cannot cope with normal bacterial growth. I'd like you to know that it is bacteria that causes wound infection, and the most common bacteria causing wound infection is methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus. Big name, right? Just call it MRSA, and it originates from the skin, other parts of the body, and the outside environment. Other causes of wound infection include, but not limited to, poor wound dressing technique, contaminated instruments, poor or unhygienic conditions, and contamination from other parts of the body. Normally, the skin contains bacteria called normal flora, which are harmless when the skin is intact. However, when the protective barrier covering the skin or the protective barrier formed by the skin is disrupted when there's a wound, these normal flora, they are able to colonize the injured area, causing infection, which can further delay or prolong the healing process. There are people that are at risk of wound infection, that's people with decreased immune functions, such as the diabetic patients, HIV patients, and even the elderly. How do you recognize an infected wound? A wound is said to be infected if it becomes hot, red, swollen, and painful, if it has pus in it, or if it begins to smell bad. Then how do you know that it has spread to other parts of the body? The infection is spreading to other parts of the body if it causes fever or if the lymph nodes becomes swollen and tender. Lymph nodes are part of the body's immune system. What they do is that they help to filter harmful substances like bacteria from the body and also fight infection. So if they become infected, or when they get infected, they form small lumps under the skin. If the wound has a bad smell, if brown or gray liquid oozes out, or if the skin around it turns black and forms air bubbles or blisters, this may be gangrene, and you need to seek medical help immediately, because gangrene is a very dangerous infection. It results when blood flow from a certain area of the body is interrupted, causing tissue decay and death. The infection begins between 6 hours and 3 days after the injury. It quickly gets worse and spreads very fast. Without treatment, it causes death within a few days. So that's why you need to seek medical attention as soon as possible, without delay. However, if you are in a place where you cannot access medical help, or you cannot get to the hospital on time, you can do some of the following. With a clean cloth, put hot compress over the wound for 10 to 15 minutes, 3 times a day. Or hold the infected part, that's the hand or the foot, over a bucket of hot water, so that the steam will help to reduce swelling, pain, and speed up the healing process. Keep the infected part at rest and elevated. Don't forget to locate the nearest hospital for further management, because you will need a shot of tetanus toxoid and antibiotics. So guys, I hope you have learned something new today. Give me a thumbs up if you find this video helpful and useful. Kindly subscribe, click on the notification bell so you'll be the first to know when I upload new videos. You can also drop your comments in the comment section below, and I will attend to them. And don't forget to share with your family and friends. I'm your next door nurse, and I'm just a knock away. I love you guys. See you in my next video.